I'm going to be planting strawberries in our new small fruits garden. Strawberries are a fairly simple fruit to grow. You could grow them throughout the state, provided you supply them with enough water. They require about an inch of irrigation per week, so you'll have to supplement if there's not adequate rain. So when you're choosing your site, be sure that you're located close to a water source. Some other considerations in your site selection are full sun, which would be about 6 to 8 hours of direct sunlight per day. Now, strawberry plants, they share some diseases in common with other fruits like raspberries and blackberries, as well as tomatoes, peppers, and other solanaceous crops. So when you're selecting your site, you want to make sure to avoid a location where you've grown any of those plants in recent years. There's three different categories of strawberry plant. There's a June-bearing variety, and despite their name, the June bearers actually produce the bulk of their fruit in May and then into early June as well. There's also an ever-bearing group of strawberries, and these produce fruit in the spring in May again, and then they'll produce some throughout the summer a little bit. And then again in the fall, they'll have another larger fruit production. But overall, fruit production on the ever-bearing varieties is lower than that of our June-bearing. The third category of strawberry is called day-neutral, and these are very sensitive to heat, and they're not recommended for Oklahoma at all. When you're purchasing plants to grow, you want to avoid taking hand-me-down plants from a neighbor or a friend, and that's because of all the diseases that are common with strawberries. It's much better to purchase your plants from a certified, from a reputable grower and make sure that they're certified as disease-free. It's also a good idea to grow more than one cultivar and to select cultivars with different maturation times. So for example, the June-bearing plants, there's some that mature a little bit earlier. There's early season, mid-season, and late season. And if you select a few different cultivars, you can extend the harvest period for your strawberries. We're going to be growing two June-bearing cultivars, All-Star and Early Glow, and also an ever-bearing cultivar called Ozark Beauty. And I have that one here. Strawberries come bare root. You have to keep these roots from drying out, so we have them all bundled up inside of our paper towels. Strawberries are typically shipped bare root. You can see the roots are exposed. This makes them very sensitive to drying out, and so you want to keep them well protected while you're working with them. I'm just keeping ours wrapped in a wet paper towel, but you can also put them in a bucket of water. I'm going to go ahead and set them back in the plastic bag also to help prevent them from drying out. Now we're planting our strawberries in a raised bed, and this is wonderful to enhance the drainage of the soil. You can also plant in mounted rows like we have here for some of our blueberries we're going to set out. And you can even plant them right in the ground, but if your soil is not well drained, you'll want to try one of these raised options instead. Strawberries are planted in, there's several different systems, but what we're going to use is called a matted row system. And this system, what it does is it relies on the strawberry plant's ability to send out runners and to fill space. So we're going to set just a few plants in this area, and we're going to rely on that, those runners and the little baby plants that they send out along those runners to fill in this space. So when we first plant it, it's not going to look very impressive. But you'll see over the summer, it'll fill up pretty quickly. And I'm going to set out two rows in our garden, and I'm going to space those. The plants themselves are going to be spaced 1.5 to 2 feet apart within our row. Your bed here should be, whether it's a raised bed or a mounded row, you only want your bed to be about 3 to 4 feet wide because you want to be able to reach to the center and harvest those berries out easily. I'm spacing my holes 2 feet apart, using a little bit of the wider spacing. And I'm going to set two rows in this, it's a 6 foot long area. I'm setting out our Ozark Beauty right now. and then I'll go back and add another row on the other side. Now the depth at which we place strawberries is critical. I'm gonna pull out this plant here. It's really quite large, and perhaps the best to demonstrate this with. So when you set strawberries, you have to place it so that the soil level is at this crown here. You kind of see this transition between the roots and where the leaves come out. So you want the soil level to be here. If you set it too shallow, then these roots are going to dry out and your plants are going to die. If you set it too deep, if the soil level's up here, this part is going to rot and your plants are also going to die. So this is one of those things that we just need to pay extra careful attention to while we're planting our strawberries. If your strawberries have many leaves on them, you want to remove all but the two or three strongest leaves. These actually look pretty good, so I'm just going to leave them as they are. We want to spread the roots out in the planting hole. And one way to ensure that our plant doesn't get set too deep and that we could get the roots wide is make sure you dig a nice wide hole so we could spread the roots out. And then take your soil and make a little mound in the bottom of the hole. And you're going to have to play around with this until you get it up high enough. That's still too low. Probably dug these a little too deep. But I wanted a nice wide hole for the roots. Some of these have quite extensive roots. And so you just need to keep adjusting it until we get that crown at the right height. So we just make a little volcano in the middle here. Okay, and now I have it raised up enough where when I fill it back in, the soil's just going to reach here. I'm going to go ahead and pull the soil in around the plant. And if you set them too deep, there's no harm in going back and trying it again, because that is very critical. We don't want to lose our strawberry plants before we get started. Sometimes the roots are a little bit long, and you could go ahead and trim those with a sharp knife or scissors. It's also a good idea to hold the plant at the crown while you're working, and that way you can sort of visualize the depth and make sure that you get it set at the right depth. Now these seem pretty sparse right now. They're only set at 2 feet apart. I'm only going to have 6 in this whole area, but each of these little plants can produce 30 to 50 runners this season. So this is going to fill up very nicely. We also want to mulch our strawberries to help retain soil moisture. It can help keep the roots cool in the summertime. We don't want to bury the plants in the mulch. But a straw mulch is ideal for strawberries. And in the winter time, we actually could come in with straw mulch and cover the entire bed to help protect them over the winter. So if you're interested in growing strawberries, you can find some more information in Fact Sheet 6214, Growing Strawberries in the Home Garden.